Hello, Elliot Brooks fans. Today is another Sean surprise on Sunday, which will be less of a surprise as I appear more on Sundays. But today we're talking about something near and dear to my heart, Avengers by Jonathan Hickman. Jonathan Hickman's run on Avengers is my second favorite comic book thing of all time, just behind Watchmen. That is how much I love it. If you don't know about Jonathan Hickman, he is a fantastic writer that I encourage you all to check out, but I think his Avengers run is a good place to start with him because it doesn't get quite as weird as sometimes he gets in other things. But the one downside of Hickman's run is it's really, really long. Hickman's entire run is covered between two omnibuses plus the Secret Wars event. Those are pretty out of print at this point, so you probably have to pay quite a bit of money to get them. I have the hardcovers. This is Avengers. He also wrote New Avengers. You have to read both series. So Avengers, New Avengers, Infinity, New Avengers, Avengers. Avengers time runs out, and Secret Wars. This is an undertaking if you want to start this journey. You do have to interweave Avengers and New Avengers kind of simultaneously. So that's why the two giant omnibuses are nice. They put the issues in the right order. If you don't have those, then I would recommend just looking for a reading order online. I found one on Reddit where it just tells you the contents of the omnibus, and then I read it that way. I believe you can still find these hardcovers out in the wild. I think they're on Amazon. So finding all of them might be a little difficult. If you really want to take the dive and read this for cheap, I would recommend Marvel Unlimited. It's like 10 bucks a month, and you can read all of Hickman's Marvel work on there. His Avengers, his Fantastic Four, S.H.I.E.L.D., Secret Avengers, all that good stuff. Or I'm sorry, Secret Warriors. So it is all on there. Like I said, you probably would need some sort of reading order so that you knew which issue to read after the next. But that is probably the best way to read it. Second best way, if you want to read it cheaply, you can find like Comixology sales for the trade paperbacks. There are seven of these hardcovers, and they usually have two trade paperbacks, so I'm guessing you'd probably need to buy like 14, maybe a little bit more with Infinity and Time Runs Out, but somewhere around there, 14, 15 trade paperbacks. But without further ado, we'll actually talk about what is this amazing run about. So what I really love about Hickman's Avengers run is it feels more like a creator-owned book. It's more of a sci-fi crazy tale than Avengers superhero comic. And it is pretty funny because I think these were coming out around the time of the first Avengers movie, so he was kind of forced into, you know, using the Avengers movie characters. So, you know, Captain America, Iron Man, Thor, Hulk, Black Widow, kind of your classic lineup, but he then expands it with just tons and tons of characters because the threats of space, aliens, all that, it's getting worse and worse. So Tony Stark and Captain America want to build this bigger Avengers team. So there's lots of characters. Some characters I didn't know, like Sunspot. I don't know who that is. I'm sure he's an X-Men. I'm sure he's great, but you really don't have to know everyone. He does a good job of, you get a brief introduction, you kind of know what they're about, and that's it. You know, you don't really need to dwell on it. What is especially cool to me is, like I said, this series was coming out when, around the first Avengers movie, and the first Avengers movie is great, I like it, but this run, like I said, is so sci-fi heavy and kind of heady in a way. And I don't think anyone ever thought that those concepts would make it into a movie, but the Marvel movies have kept building and building. If you really liked the Infinity War movie, I would definitely say you should check this out because Hickman's kind of the end of the first chunk of his run ends with this event called Infinity. And a lot of the plot and a lot of the characters you see in the Infinity Wars movie come from Hickman's creation here. It's kind of a combination. The movie is a combination of this event and then also Starling's Infinity Gauntlet. So if you've read that and you read this, you can kind of see where the movie concept came from. I think I said Starling, but I meant Starlin. Jim Starlin was the author of Infinity Gauntlet. So check that out as well if you want more about Infinity Wars and how that movie came to be. So getting into more details about this run, what I really like about it is in the Avengers title, so like I said at the beginning, he wrote Avengers and New Avengers simultaneously. It's kind of all been called now just Hickman's Avengers run, but they were at the time being printed as two separate books. So Avengers is Captain America's team. He's making this giant team to take on these intergalactic threats, and that's cool. You're like, wow, this is so great. What the better part is, though, is New Avengers, which is Namor, Doctor Strange, Black Panther, Iron Man, Reed Richards, Black Bolt, and Beast from the X-Men. And what I really like about all these characters is they think they know everything, especially Reed Richards and Mr. Tony Stark. That Reed Richards is quite a piece of work. I don't know if I was never a huge, like, yeah, Fantastic Four, they're so cool. I was never that person until I read Hickman's Fantastic Four, and then Reed shows up in this too. I'm like, yeah, that seems about right. Anyways, what I was saying is all these characters think they know everything. They basically discover this threat to our world. They have to make some really hard moral choices, and they essentially don't trust Captain America to be a part of their little group, because Captain America, he's too good. So this group of characters decides they're going to shoulder this giant responsibility and take on all this guilt and shame in order to protect the Earth. And it's fascinating watching them just eat up at them. If you think you know these characters, you probably may not. Hickman definitely, he challenges the reader. You may not end up liking a lot of them, which is saying something since, you know, everyone loves Tony Stark, you know, from the movies, and everyone loves Black Panther. New Avengers definitely just, it takes it to another level. I was surprised that Hickman was able to do this in a book that was, like, you know, one of Marvel's flagship books, because they just launched a giant movie. Definitely check out New Avengers. It works better with Avengers, but if you had to choose one, I think I'd advocate this series. It does cross with Avengers for the Infinity event, which I showed you earlier, so you kind of probably have to read all of those. Everything that these characters have been doing, it comes to the forefront in the Time Runs Out event. So that's when things really get crazy. Secrets are revealed. People start getting upset. It's fantastic. The run as a whole culminates in Secret Wars, which is Hickman's kind of capstone, his final event. It kind of takes stuff from his Fantastic Four, his Avengers, maybe a little bit from Secret Warriors, but it just ends with this amazing event. I actually really love Secret Wars. It features my favorite villain, Mr. Doctor Doom. One criticism I see of Hickman, his work in general, is sometimes they're not the most character-driven stories. It's all about the plot, and I'd say that's actually fairly accurate, but I will say in this run, he did a great job of developing Thor as a character. I don't know if I would have really cared about Thor, but Thor develops this relationship with another hero, Hyperion. If you don't know Hyperion, that's okay. You learn all about Hyperion. And it's a fun little, they have like this this kind of buddy, you know, they're just like pals. It's really interesting. But Thor has two great moments in the series that are just like, wow, Thor is amazing. He's awesome. I'm just I'm just gushing about the series, and I hope you forgive me. You should try to read it. Read it on Comixology. Read it on Marvel Unlimited. Get it from the library. It might be on Hoopla. Any way you can. Try to read Hickman's Avengers, because I don't think you'll be disappointed. I will say it gets super nerdy. You gotta be okay with all the sci-fi craziness. That's if I had to sum it up, it's the heroes you know from the movies, but with just the craziest sci-fi, bizarre, end-of-the-world situations cranked up to 11. If that sounds like a good time, and it is, you just go read it. And that is about it for this review. I was just casually flipping through right this second. I'm like, wow, I need to reread this, because I finished it about a year ago, so now I need to read it again. It's the perfect time. Definitely try to check this out. I don't think you'll be disappointed. So that's it. Read Jonathan Hickman's Avengers. Subscribe to Elliot's amazing channel. I just appear to talk about picture books because they're fun. And that is about it. Thank you for watching.